Thank you for joining us here at Tritive Health Family Healing Center. It's starting to get a bit dark, but it looks like you can still see me. Huh? What do you think? Pretty good? Good. So this is our food series, Tritive Health at Tritive Health, TRIADOFHEALTH.NET. And of course, there's the Women's Kinesiology website, womenskinesiology.com, womenskinesiology.com. So thus far, I don't know what order you're going to watch these videos in, but we've discussed nuts and seeds and legumes and beans and grains to the fairly well. We've discussed apples, oranges, peaches, plums, pears, apricots, basically fruits and their sugar content. And what's left to discuss? We could discuss spicy food if you want. Why not? So spicy food, I already have the 9 videos on the spicy food. They're called ileocecal valve diagnosis and treatment. But we can continue if you're going to find it helpful. Spicy food, spicy and hard on the tongue means difficult on the gut. Okay. So we should review the 5 fingers of death. Okay. Like a karate movie. Whoa. Whoop-a. The 5 fingers of death. Okay. 5 fingers of death are wheat, death, dairy, not good, corn, not good, soy, ooh, it's the triangle, okay, and processed sugar, not good, okay. If you want to really get a great injection, get a good high, take some cupcakes, dip them in honey, add some frosting, drink a few cups of milk, and then drink some coffee, okay, have that with some donuts, okay, some Krispy Kremes, and then go eat some sushi with lots of edamame and soy sauce, and then have some polenta and, you know, some nice corn on the cob that same night, maybe before going to sleep. See how you feel the next day. Okay, let me know. Call the office. Okay, 415-459-4313. These are the 5 fingers of death. Wheat, dairy, corn, soy, processed sugar. I'm not yelling at you. I'm just trying to help you understand it. Wheat, gluteomorphins. They're known to cause almost every disease you've ever heard of that's a chronic disease. Ulcerative colitis, rheumatoid arthritis, Graves' disease, Hashimoto's, headaches, high blood pressure, heart disease, high cholesterol levels, depression, ADD, ADHD. Are you getting it? Excuse my excitement. Believe me, I know you get it. I'm sorry to give you a hard time. So wheat's not so good. Read Gut and Psychology Syndrome by Dr. Natasha Campbell McBride. Weston Price's book, Nutrition and Physical Degeneration by Dr. Weston Price. Read through some of the literature out there. Separating the Wheat from the Chaff by Noel Thomas, ND. That's harder to find in the bookstores. You have to really search for it on the internet. But I can direct you to it if you'd like. So read, there's Wheat Belly, or I think that's what it's called. Wheat Belly, there's a lot of books about wheat out now. So dairy, caseomorphins. Did you know that there's opiate chemicals? There's opium in wheat and opium in dairy. So when people eat wheat and dairy, even if they're allergic to it, a lot of times they just feel good from the allergic response. I've had patients so sick from having milk that they're getting pituitary tumors. Yeah, I know the video is going for more than 4 minutes and you're getting tired of listening to me, but seriously, if you have a pituitary tumor or if you have a problem with the communication between your pituitary and your gut, and now you're having some kind of a, let's say, you know, a major hormonal imbalance, like a pituitary tumor or some little polyps in the colon. The colon is over in this, you know, the colon's down here. That's not your stomach. Stomach's all the way on the left, up here, actually, above the rib cage. But so wheat and dairy, gluteomorphins and caseomorphins, corn causes diarrhea, dermatitis, depression, and dementia, probably not so good. eventually it'll cause death if you keep eating it. They've done the research on that in the 40s. I mean, this is not new stuff. This has been around for years and years. Wheat, dairy, corn, soy, I just talked about in the previous video. It's been outlawed in New Zealand. So I think soy, we got it because we talked about that with nuts and seeds. Sugar, so much information in the media now. You should be able to get, you know, Fed Up is a great movie about sugar. Forks Over Knives is more about animals and how terrible they are, you know, taken advantage of and the manufacturing process. Just eat organic stuff. Have wild, you know, wild animals that are, you know, free-range chickens and free-range cattle. I mean, I eat beef. A lot of people want to eat buffalo instead of beef. Buffalo has more protein. Beef has more fat. The fat is great. And you feel full afterwards. The more fat you eat, the more fat you burn. You don't gain weight by eating fat. So, good. Good video, huh? Glad you liked it. Okay. We're going to see you on the next video.